like one tribal leader.
Where I'm alive, I am done, tribal leader.
Run your shawala, tribal Benjamin.
Yankwan, tribal leader.
Run, run, run. Son, yo, tribal leader.
The man, tribal leader.
Hurry up, son, tribal shooter. I'm an honor, tribal leader. Down, down, tribal Benjamin. Down, down, tribal Benjamin.
Emilio, tribal Zebulon.
Therefore is the enemy eager to destroy all that call upon the Lord. For he knows that upon the day on which Israel shall repent, then the kingdom of the enemy shall be brought to an end.
Read it again for me.
Therefore is the enemy eager to destroy all that call upon the Lord. For he knows that upon the day on which Israel shall repent, then the kingdom of the enemy shall be brought to an end.
The enemy knows that the day Israel repent, this kingdom shall be brought to an end. This is why they don't want us to follow God's law. Because once we repent and come back to these laws, this kingdom will fall.
Amen.
That's why they have Facebook, Twitter, all these things to make sure this you stay out of the Bible. This is the whole purpose, destruction, to distract you from following God's law. Knowing that once Israel repent, once Israel repent, this kingdom will fall. Okay? Once Israel repent, this kingdom is fall. This has been hidden from us. This has been used as a weapon against us to make sure we never repent. We never, at some level, revive ourselves. We never shake ourselves from the dust and come back to the Most High. Okay? Through Facebook now, everybody's looking for how many views they have. Who's been watching them? People wasting time on social media. It's a trick. You've been fooled. You've been deceived. Because they know if you repent and come back to this law, their kingdom will fall. Alright? Let's go to 2 Maccabees 8 and 36.
2 Maccabees chapter 8, verse 36. Thus he that took upon him to make good to the Romans their tribute by means of the captives in Jerusalem told abroad that the Jews had God to fight for them, and therefore they could not be hurt because they followed the laws that he gave them.
The Jews could not be hurt. Why? Because they followed the law that God had given them. Now, we've been destroyed everywhere. Why? We're not following the law he had given us. They know the trick. They know how to overcome you. They know if you disobey this God, he'll make sure he punish you. They have to find a way to make sure you stay out of the law, out of the Bible. Because they know if this true God, the God who created heaven and earth, if he's with you, then they can't touch you.
Amen.
They are aware of that, and they're using it against you as a weapon. Let's go to the book of Judith and the Apocrypha again, the 11th chapter. So verse 10 and 11. I'm going to show you. The book of Judith, the 11th chapter.
Judith, chapter 11, verse 10. Therefore, O Lord and Governor, reject not his word, but lay it up in thy heart, for it is true. For our nation shall not be punished, neither can the sword prevail against them, except they sin against their God.
Except we sin against our God, nothing can prevail against us. We cannot be punished, nor sword, nor weapons can come against us. But once we sin, we provoke the Most High God to anger, and they know it. And that's how they're fighting us. That's how they're destroying us, by having us sin. This is a sinful kingdom. That's why the Most High said, get out of my people, so you don't partake of her sin. It is a sinful kingdom, man. They know if we sin, then the Most High will provoke the Most High to anger. Read it again for me.
Judith, chapter 11, verse 10. Therefore, O Lord and Governor, reject not his word, but lay it up in thy heart. For it is true, for our nation shall not be punished.
Our nation, it is true that our nation shall not be punished. Read.
Neither can the sword prevail against them.
No weapon formed shall be able to prosper against us. Read.
Except they sin against their God.
Except we sin against our God who created heaven and earth. That's the only way. That's how they were able to put us down. Read.
Verse 11. And now that my Lord be not defeated and frustrate of his purpose, even death is now fallen upon them, and their sin hath overtaken them.
Even death is follow us, and our sin hath overtaken us. Read.
Wherewith they will provoke their God to anger, whosoever they shall do that which is not fit to be done.
Whenever we do that which is not fit to be done, whenever we break God's law, guess what? We are provoking the Most High God, a higher, unto anger. And they know it. By having us sin, by having us breaking God's law everywhere, by saying the law, the Most High God's law is done away with. So therefore, we are provoking the Most High God to anger by breaking these laws. And they know it too. They know it. We're supposed to be a strong people following God's law. And that's how they were able to take us down as a nation. That's how they were able to take us down from Africa to over here.
It has to be a spiritual phenomenon. It had to be, man. Because we break God's law. That's how they were able to get us over here. It was because of our sin. We have nobody else to blame but ourselves. Let's go to Deuteronomy 32. Let's start at 29.
We have nobody else to blame but ourselves. Through our sin, we were able to be brought low because of our sin. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 29. Oh, that they were wise, that they understood this, that they would consider their latter end. Verse 30. How should one chase 1,000 and two put 10,000 to flight?
How is one is able to chase 1,000? One man. One Israelite brother was able to chase 1,000 men. Two was able to chase how many?
How should one chase 1,000 and two put 10,000 to flight?
Two brothers were able to put 10,000 men to flight. Why? Because the law of the Most High God was with us. But when we sin, listen, man, the shaking of a leaf put us to flight. Like it says in Leviticus, the 26th and the 17th verse. Okay? We flee when no one even pursues us. We run. But if we were keeping God's law, it wouldn't be this way, man. Read again for me.
Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 30. How should one chase 1,000 and two put 10,000 to flight, except their rock had sold them?
That's why they are able to put us in captivity. The Most High sold us, man. Otherwise, one of us, just one of us, would have put 1,000 to flight. One of us, man. But we need to do something. We need to repent and come back to these laws. Because the Most High's law is our strength. We are strong when we're keeping God's law. Let's read that in Deuteronomy 11 and 8. We're strong when we keep God's law. But the whole world makes it seem like we can't keep God's law. But that's a lie. It's a trick. You've been tricked. Okay? Deuteronomy 11 and 8.
Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 8. Therefore shall ye keep all the commandments which I command you this day, that ye may be strong and go in and possess the land.
That he may be strong. Keep all the laws that I have given you so you can be strong. The law is our strength, man. The law is our strength. When we keep God's law, we're strong. We will be able to put a man, one man will be able to put 1,000 men to flight through the law. The law is settled in heaven forever. The law is spiritual. The law is divine. It gives us strength. But if we don't keep these laws, man, we'll be on the bottom forever. And this is what this kingdom is waiting for. This is what this kingdom wants. But guess what? We have to repent. And the Most High is waiting on us. Once we rise, this whole kingdom is fall. Let's go to Psalms 81, 13 and 14. Once we rise, man, this whole kingdom is going to fall. The Most High is waiting on us to rise. Read.
Psalms chapter 81, verse 13. All that my people had hearkened unto me.
All that my people would hear my voice. They would hear my law. Read.
And Israel had walked in my ways. Verse 14. I should soon have subdued their enemies and turned my hand against their adversaries.
That's what was is going to happen once we return to the law of the Most High God. He will subdue our enemies and he will bless us. He will rise us up again. Read it again for me, the 14th verse.
Verse 14, I should soon have subdued their enemies and turned my hand against their adversaries.
This is what's going to happen. This is what they were afraid of. They were afraid of us rising up, keeping God's law. Because they know the day that we do that, their kingdom shall be brought to an end.
Amen! Amen! Amen!